In this presentation, we're going to explore time management for distance learning, how you can use time management to teach a better class. This begins by understanding the purpose of training, by understanding what the learning objectives are. It's important to understand what the learning objectives are because now you can determine how much time will you spend on these learning objectives based on the amount of time you have to teach the class, to what depth and to what extent will you explore these learning objectives so that you are using the effective timing in proportion to what must be taught in the class. You also need to understand your audience. By understanding your audience, you're trying to determine how will they use this information that you are going to convey. How will they take what they've learned in the class and apply it to their day-to-day jobs? And then finally, we need to make certain that we are transferring knowledge. The concept of knowledge transfer is that you have an idea or a concept or an understanding, and then you are conveying that and transferring that information so that someone else can understand that as well. There is the idea of transmitting knowledge. Knowledge transmission is like this radio tower where you're just sending out a signal and there's no proof of receipt. You don't know if anyone's getting what you are transmitting or not. Now transfer, there is acknowledgement, and that acknowledgement in the classroom comes by exercises and questions and feedbacks, so there's a constant evaluation and confirmation that our audience is understanding the learning objectives that we're giving them in the set amount of time that we have for the class. It's important to discuss the learning objectives, so with your manager or the training director or the client or even the people in the classroom. We need to understand why is this training happening? What is the point of the training? What's the root cause of the training? That helps me in the scope of time management because I can focus on the core priorities, what's most important to my learners in the class. Also in the learning objectives, we will understand how will learners use this material. So what are they going to do with the information that we give them? And again, that allows me as the instructor to focus on what's most important for my learners. Every class, virtual class or face-to-face instructor-led training, should always begin with an agenda. An agenda allows me to discuss and to communicate the objectives for the classroom. What are we going to do in the amount of time that we have available? So it helps us to determine what's important. It helps us to convey what the participants will learn, and it communicates the flow of the class material on how we're going to go from the beginning of the class, cover all of the wealth of information, and then finally end the class. This communicates to our participants expectations and boundaries. We're showing them what they can expect to learn from this class and what is in and out of the boundaries of the class. That helps with time management because we only have so much time to convey and communicate the expectations. So if there's topics that people are interested in, they may fall outside of the boundaries of this class, and we don't have enough time to do that. So it helps to communicate expectations and boundaries. In your agenda, it's a good idea to communicate rest breaks. When will we take breaks in the morning, in the afternoon, and when's lunch? That will allow people to focus on the learning objectives and not so much when that next cup of coffee is going to happen. In a virtual environment, it's important to establish the class rules. Now, the class rules in a virtual environment usually focus on how the participants will interact with you, the presenter, how they'll interact with the host, which could be a moderator. It may also be you. You could play both roles in the virtual classroom environment. And then how will they participate with one another? So how will they chat with each other? Now, in the Cisco virtual classroom, in the meeting properties, we can set some options here about how people can chat privately or publicly. So you want to go in and determine what's most appropriate for the topic that you're teaching and the audience that you're teaching with, or two, how can they chat with each other. And then throughout the meeting, you may go in and change some of these preferences if it's getting out of hand or you want to focus the communication a bit more on what you're teaching in that class. Focus is a key word when it comes to training, that we want to keep our class focused on what we are communicating. And we can do this best by knowing our topic, knowing what we're about to teach on. If we understand what must be accomplished and we're well-versed in that topic, then we're better instructors and we'll have an easier time at time management during that class. If we go back to the idea of learning objectives, we can understand what's most important and then we can focus accordingly. So we set priorities among those learning objectives. If you've ever taught a class, you probably have realized that you have some learners that are going to be more advanced based on their experience with the technology, and then that same classroom, you may have some individuals that are very new to the technology you're teaching. So you need to balance those learners, learn how to manage the time so that some people aren't bored and getting restless while other people are struggling to keep up. So time management also focuses on the balance of the learners and how do you manage that dichotomy of users in your classroom. Always focus on the learning objectives. You only have so much time to teach that class, so you want to focus on what's most important and focus on the learning objectives.